Hey guys, I hate long YouTube intros, so this will be a 30-second explanation of what this is, then we'll get right into it. This video and the series, if I decide to do more, is intended for intermediate and advanced German learners. We're going to be reading a book together, a famous crime novel called Der Richter und sein Henker. I'll be reading and encouraging you to read along, and I will stop to point out some grammar, usage, and maybe challenge you to interpret and translate things at some points. Think of this as a live guided reader. Sound fun? Then let's get started. Hallo, liebe Zuschauer, herzlich willkommen. So today we're going to be reading Der Richter und sein Henker, das erste Kapitel. I'm going to be reading it. And we're going to do some analysis of a little bit of grammar and some vocabulary we come across, how things are worded. And it's just a couple pages, and you can see it's big print here. So we're going to go through all this. How about that? It'll be fun. Der Richter und sein Henker is the title of the book. It's quite a famous book. Ein Krimi, right? Which you may have heard of. The Germans love their Krimis. Those are criminal serials, criminal novels or crime stories and that kind of thing. It's often read as a contemporary literature piece in German high schools, middle schools, and so forth. The difficulty of the book is not too big, but our author, Friedrich Dürrenmatt, is from Switzerland. I believe he's from Switzerland. I guess I should have looked this up and prepared a little better, but whatever. Whatever, we're just having fun. At the very least, this takes place in Switzerland. So what you're going to see is a lot of French or French-ish names. And the Germans, first tip here, like to pronounce French stuff kind of like French, right? But with a German accent. So if you speak French already or you are French, it might be a bit of a mind screw for you. But if you don't, this is a good chance to practice your German-French accent where you say French stuff kind of like a French person but with a heavy German accent. So we're going to start right off. So I'm not going to be going over everything, obviously, because you're expected to understand some of this, especially common vocabulary. But I will point out interesting things or difficult things and explain things and sort of translate it as we go along. All right, so try to follow along. I'm going to start by reading. Erstes Kapitel. Alphonse Clénin, der Polizist von Twan, fand am Morgen des 3. November 1948 dort, wo die Straße von Lambouin, eines der Tessenbergdörfer, aus dem Walde der Twanbachschlucht hervortritt, einen blauen Mercedes, der am Straßenrande stand. Okay. Now, he's not being very nice to us, the author, with this first sentence. This is a classic German sentence that people hate, right? This is, it got a very long embedded clause, and I'll be honest, the first time I read this sentence, I did have to read it twice because I got hung up on all these locations and stuff, and especially because of this. So to interpret this sentence, let's just ignore this dot, right? This dot is causing a problem for us because all this stuff with these locations and junk, that's coming from this dot explaining what's there. So we're going to ignore this just to help us better understand. This is what I do sometimes if I if I'm reading something kind of complicated or difficult, you can just break it down. So Alphonse Clénin, der Polizist von Twan, should be obvious, fand am Morgen des 3. November 1948, skipping dort in this embedded clause, einen blauen Mercedes, der am Straßenrande stand. Okay, so what did he find on the morning of the 3rd of November, 1948? Take a second if your numbers are good, right? 1900, 48, 8 and 40, 1948. Aus dem Walde der Twanbachschlucht, let's ignore this. Ein blauer Mercedes am Straßenrande stand. So what you're going to see, this happens twice really quick here. So notice this. Walde, Straßenrande. So this is something that you may be familiar with this. In fact, I think you all know some instances of this happening. What this is a dative E, okay? This doesn't really happen in German, modern German anymore at all, right? What you do know, though, is the dative N. So I've got a little extra sheet of paper prepared in case I need to write something. So the dative N, obviously, is in the plural dative, you need to add an N to stuff if it doesn't already have an N or if it's not some particular exceptional word. All right, so like you can say then Kinder, right, hat der Film gefallen. Right, so we know dative N, den Kindern. Right, so that's actually, maybe you didn't know this, that actually used to be a rule to add this dative E on masculine and neuter things. Okay, so we're going to see this all the time in this book. This book isn't too old. It was published in the 50s, if I recall. So that means it's sort of right on the edge of where this started to fall out of favor. But this dative E that's added on the end of, so we can see here, am Straßenrande. Der Rand is the margin or the side of something. Not the side as in like a face of a cube, but the side as in like to the side or the margin, right? Straßenrand would be the margin of the street to the side of the street. Am Straßenrande. On dem dative, you add an E because that's masculine there. Same thing with der Wald. Aus dem Walde, adding an E. This exists today in set phrases, mostly in like im Sinne von, if you've ever heard that one, in the sense of or meaning. Also zu Hause, everyone knows this one. Zu Hause, right? Why is that E there? Like we know the word Haus, but Hause, because it's a dative E. It's an upset expression. Okay, so we'll see that. Don't worry about it. And you'll actually see the characters don't use that sometimes when they speak. So you can kind of tell it's right on the edge of where this was typical German. Maybe a German's going to tell me I'm a dummy and this is actually used all the time in written German still, like in novels and stuff. But I kind of doubt it. So either way. Don't worry about this E. So he found, let's get back to this, einen blauen Mercedes, der am Straßenrande stand, a blue Mercedes that at the street side stood, right? That was sitting or standing, that was at the side of the street, to the side of the street. And so this whole bunch of junk here, dort. So this is something they do in German often. They set up this embedded clause with a dort, right, to explain where something happened, right? So this is just a nice way to set up, like, hey, where is this happening, by the way? Dort, wo. Now we start this whole thing. And this isn't too complicated if you can get over the Swiss names and stuff. Wo die Straße von Lambois, eines der Tessenbergdörfer. So Lambois is eines der Tessenbergdörfer. Dörfer, villages, Tessenberg, the Tessenberg. Right, that's an area in Switzerland, mountains probably. There's a lot of mountains in Switzerland. If you say that about pretty much anywhere, you'll be right. Aus dem Walde, so the street from Lambois, which is one of the Tessenberg villages, out of the woods, der Twanenbachschlucht hervortritt. Okay, Twanbach, Twan is a place in Switzerland. Bach is like a water source, river, creek or something. Twanbach Schlucht, right? A Schlucht, that's sort of a ravine or a crevice or a kettle. Like you can think of this like, it reminds me sort of the word schlucken, right? When you take a gulp or a sip of something. So sort of where the water flows down into. So the Twanbach Gorge, Twanbach Ravine. Right? Hervortritt, steps forward, right? Where it emerges from. Emerges from all this. So basically, he found in this place, in this specific spot where the road is emerging from the woods of the Twanbach Gorge, he found a blue Mercedes sitting on the side of the street. Right? Es herrschte Nebel, wie oft in diesem Spätherbst, und eigentlich war Klinar am Wagen schon vorbeigegangen, als doch wieder zurückkehrte. Okay, so es herrschte Nebel. So this is a verb, herrschen. Right? I want to spell it wrong. Herrschen, okay? To reign or rule, right? So in English, we use this in one particular phrase, I think only one, chaos reigned, right? If you, I arrived on scene and chaos reigned, right? That's sort of sort of an artistic way of saying something. But Germans can use this for all sorts of things, right? So es herrschte Nebel. So this is the passive S. Right? Like, es stehen hier zwei Menschen or something like that. There are two people standing here. Es stehen hier zwei Menschen. That's passive. Es herrschte Nebel. So it rained, not rain, but reign. Fog rained here. Okay? So fog was all over the place, is what that's saying. Okay? I hope this hasn't been too far to the side of the frame. I think this may have gotten a little off center at some point, so if that's infuriating to you, I deeply apologize. Verzeihung. So fog was everywhere. It rained fog. Wie oft in diesem Spätherbst? Don't get hung up on this. This is just spät and herbst, late spring. Wie oft in diesem Spätherbst? Right? So this is sort of saying in late spring, which is the current season, right? In diesem Spätherbst, not in this late spring only, right? Wie in diesem Spätherbst, but in late spring, in its late spring. Und eigentlich war Klina am Wagen schon vorbeigegangen. Actually, or honestly, indeed, war Klina am Wagen schon vorbeigegangen. He was, right? So in this case, how do I know if I meant he had or he had been? We're going to see in the next sentence, actually. War Klina, or next clause. War Klina am Wagen schon vorbeigegangen. Vorbei, past, is in going past something. Gegangen, walked, or going. So he had already been walking past the wagon, als doch wieder zurückkehrte. As he doch, so doch is sort of canceling out in this case. So doch, I'm sure you know, does the 10 million things in the German language. In this case, it's sort of canceling out this previous clause. As doch wieder zurückkehrte. So he had been going past it, but then he turned back again. Zurückkehren is to return, and wieder is sort of is again. So zurückkehrte, turned back again. So fog was everywhere, as it often is in late spring. And Clénat had actually walked past the wagon, or had actually already walked past the wagon, as he decided to double back. Es war ihm nämlich beim Vorbeischreiten gewesen, es war ihm nämlich beim Vorbeischreiten gewesen, nachdem er flüchtig durch die trüben Scheiben des Wagens geblickt hatte, als sei der Fahrer auf das Steuer niedergesunken. Right? It was to him, namely, by stepping past, so this is schritten, schreiten, right? So that's where the word Schritt comes from. Schreiten is to just step or advance or move a pace. Vorbeischreiten, so basically the same thing as vorbeigegangen, right? Same, really the same thing right there. Just another way of wording it. So it was, war gewesen. It had been, namely, to him as he walked past. So to really translate this, we'd have to get more information, and we're going to get it here. So this is just saying to him it seemed, basically. Nachdem er flüchtig, so flüchtig does not mean like fluchtartig. Don't get confused with anything like that. It doesn't mean like as he was running past, but flüchtig is like briefly, right? In a fleeting, like we even have it's related to English, the word fleeting, right? To like fleeing. To take flight can mean to run away, to flee. So fleeting has the same root in English as flüchtig here. It's the same connection. Durch die trüben Scheiben des Wagens geblickt hatte. Trüben is like unclear or foggy or darkened or whatever. It's unclear. Scheiben, so is a slice or a pane of glass. So the pane of glass of the car is, of course, the window, the car window. So he fleetingly glimpsed through, durch die, Akkusativ, Scheiben des Wagens geblickt hatte. So, all right. So it was, so really, es war ihm nämlich beim Vorbeischreiten gewesen. So it was only really as he was walking past, after he had briefly glimpsed through the darkened windows, as he glimpsed or glanced or looked through the darkened windows fleetingly, as it looked as though, so es war ihm gewesen, it had been to him, so it looked to him as though, I know this is getting complicated, bear with me, as though the driver auf der Steuer niedergesunken, as sei, das Konjunktiv 2, So it's saying this is reporting his, it's not narrating the reality, but it's saying his impression. Also der Fahrer auf der Steuer niedergesunken. As if the driver was sunken or slumped down onto, not on top of, but auf das, because it's accusative, onto, doesn't really matter, but onto the steering wheel. Glaubte, dass der Mann betrunken sei, denn als ordentlicher Mensch kam auf das Nächstliegende. Okay? So he believed that the man may be or is drunk, betrunken sei, den als ordentlicher Mensch, so in this case orderly, the Germans love to use ordentlich, ordentlicher Mensch, and ordentlicher Mensch is a proper person, a proper man. So he's a man of good sense. Den als ordentlicher Mensch kam auf das Nächstliegende. Nächstliegend, right? Nächst is next, or actually close, right? That's why the word nah for near, the superlative is nächste, right? And in German, I don't know if you made this connection before. It took me a long time actually, but maybe I'm just slow. Nächst. So when you talk about like das nächste Mal, the next time, really it's the nearest time. It's the most near time. So that's how the Germans say next. They say it's the most near. So the most near, or the next lying, the nearest lying, okay? The nearest lying thing, das nächst, so this is an adjective, nächstliegend, and we're nominalizing it, right? It takes the E ending because it's nominal or actually accusative. Das nächstliegende. So nächstliegend, after all this buildup, what is the nearest lying or the next lying thing it mean? It means the most sensible thing, or the most obvious or likely thing. So he thought the man was drunk because, as a good-headed, sensible man, kam auf das Nächstliegende. He comes to, so he makes the assumption of the most obvious thing, or the most logical thing. Wollte daher dem Fremden nicht amtlich, sondern menschlich begegnen. Right? Begegnen, you should know this word for sure, to run into somebody or to approach somebody. Wollte daher, for that reason, he wanted to, dem Fremden, to, he wanted to the stranger, nicht amtlich, sondern menschlich. All right, so this is one of those things that just feels so nice in German. It feels nice to say, and you couldn't quite say it this way in English. He wanted to approach the stranger, nicht amtlich, sondern menschlich. So amtlich would be in the course of duty. Amt, right? If you think of Amtskollege, for example, Amt is like the officer bureau, right? The officer bureau. Or, generally, it's sort of a general stand-in for anything related to working or in the course of duty, right? So amtlich is in the course of work, or so in his capacity as a police officer. Right? We know he's der Polizist von Tvan. Sondern menschlich, but as a person. So he wants to approach him not as a police officer, not in the course of duty of a police officer, rather as a person. Okay, so we know he's going to treat this guy probably nice, right? He's not going to arrest this guy. That's what we're hearing in this sentence. He wants to approach him not as a police officer in the line of duty, but rather just as a fellow human. Trat mit der Absicht ans Automobil, den Schlafenden zu wecken, ihn nach Twan zu fahren und dem Hotel Bären bei schwarzem Kaffee und einer Mehlsuppe nüchtern werden zu lassen. Denn es war zwar verboten, betrunken zu fahren, aber nicht verboten, betrunken in einem Wagen, der am Straßenrande stand, zu schlafen. Okay? Long sentence, but it's got a semicolon. So he stepped with the intention to the, up to the automobile. To wake the sleeping man, him, all right, we're drive him to Zwan, and in the Hotel Bären, bei schwarzem Kaffee und einer Mehlsuppe, nüchtern werden zu lassen. Nüchtern, like recover. To let him be recovered. Nüchtern werden zu lassen. To let him become recovered, right? And what is he gonna do? How's he going to do that? By, so in this case we translate it as recover over or by way of. By schwarzem Kaffee und einer Mehlsuppe, right? By coffee and soup. Denn es war zwar verboten, betrunken zu fahren, right? But it was Well, it was rather forbidden to drive drunk, but nicht verboten, not forbidden, betrunken in einem Wagen, der am Straßenrande stand, zu schlafen. But, right, so he's saying, he's like, I'm going to use this loophole. I'm not going to assume this guy drove because I'm going to be a nice man. I'm going, ich will ihn, so I want to approach him menschlich, not amtlich. So it wasn't illegal, obviously, to sit drunk in a car sitting at the side of the road. Klinau öffnete die Wagentür und legte dem Fremden die Hand väterlich auf die Schultern. Er bemerkte jedoch im gleichen Augenblick, dass der Mann tot war. Ah, here we go, the mystery begins, finally. Okay, I mean, it didn't take long, it just took a while because I've been explaining all this stuff. Okay, Klinau öffnete die Wagentür und legte dem Fremden die Hand väterlich auf die Schultern. Okay, so he opened the car door and lay the stranger his hand in a fatherly way on his shoulders, right? On his shoulder. Well, we wouldn't translate this auf die Schultern because it's die Hand, so maybe we can assume this implies in German he's putting both hands on the shoulders, or maybe just putting one on his shoulder, whatever. Er bemerkte jedoch im gleichen Augenblick, he however noticed in the same moment, Augenblick, you probably know this one, but if you don't, blink of an eye. Augenblick. In the blink of an eye is not quite so fast as it is in English. In German, it just means at that very moment. So, he however noticed in that very moment, that same moment, dass der Mann tot war. The man was dead. Die Schläfen waren durchschossen. Sorry, die Schläfen waren durchschossen. Right? I'm not perfect. Die Schläfen waren durchschossen. Die Schläfen, it's what you schlafen, right? Right? So, what do you schlafen an? Die Schläfen, your temples, the side of your head, waren durchschossen. Right? They were shot through. Shot through. So he shot through the temples. Auch sah Klinar jetzt, dass die rechte Wagentür offen stand. He also saw now that the right car door was standing open, was sitting open. Im Wagen war nicht viel Blut und der dunkelgraue Mantel, den die Leiche trug, schien nicht einmal beschmutzt. All right. In the car was not much blood. And der dunkelgraue Mantel, right, so this is changing the subject because Mantel is masculine. We're not saying in the dark gray coat. We're just saying, okay, now, der dunkelgraue Mantel, den die Leiche trug. So this is an important word. If you like Krimis, if you want to learn about those or read more of those, you're going to see this word 10 million times. Die Leiche, that means the corpse or the body, dead body. Okay. Im Wagen war nicht viel Blut und der dunkelgraue Mantel, den die Leiche trug. So the dark gray coat that the corpse or the body wore, schien nicht einmal beschmutzt. Seemed not once dirtied. Okay. So it didn't seem at all dirty. So it didn't have the slightest, it was spotless, basically. Aus der Manteltasche glänzte der Rand einer gelben Brieftasche. Okay, Brieftasche is a pocket, right? Brief is a letter. So a letter pocket is actually like a, not like a wallet, but it's like a holder, like a carry of ID and stuff, probably. So out of the coat pocket shined the edge of a yellow wallet or a holder or something. Klinar, der sie hervorzog, konnte ohne Mühe feststellen, dass es sich beim Toten um Ulrich Schmid handelte, Polizeileutnant der Stadt Bern. Ooh, so this is a big deal. You see what happened? Polizeileutnant, so Klinar, der sie hervorzog, who pulled him forward, right? Pulled him towards him, konnte ohne Mühe feststellen, could without trouble feststellen, confirm. Could be confirmed without trouble, so he immediately saw this, dass es sich beim Toten um Ulrich Schmid handelte. Right? Sich um etwas handeln? You probably know this phrase, but if you don't, it's very important to know. It means it's about, right? The deal is, the situation is, right? They say this in German way more than we do in English. Es handelt sich um etwas, right? It's about something. What's going on is this. The topic or the what's happened is this, right? So here, Beim Toten, regarding the dead body, es handelt sich um Schmied, Polizeileutnant der Stadt Bern. Right? So regarding the body, so the body, really, there's no good way to translate this, I don't think. You're just gonna say the body is police lieutenant Schmied from the city of Bern in Switzerland. Dass sich beim Toten. So yeah, I don't think I can think of a good way to translate this. That's why it's so important to know this. Sich, so, you know, sich um etwas handeln. Very important. That looks like an H. L N. Handeln. Klinau wusste nicht recht, was er tun sollte. He didn't quite know, properly know, he didn't quite know what he should do. Als Dorfpolizist war ihm ein so blutiger Fall noch nie vorgekommen. Okay? This is next sentence when I just read that, sorry. As Dorfpolizist is a village police officer. Okay? So he's probably, and it says here, he says, der Polizist von Twan, implying perhaps, maybe he's the only police officer from Twan. This is a very small, but it could be just saying, it's sort of giving him his title, so we don't know if that really means the only police officer, but he's definitely a small time, right? Definitely small time because Dorfpolizist. So as a village police officer, war ihm ein so blutiger Fall noch nie vorgekommen. Vorkommen is to occur, so it's never occurred to him. He's never had to deal with such a bloody case. Right, a bloody case because it's a murder, obviously. Wasn't much blood in the car, but it's a murder, so it's bloody. Er lief am Straßenrande hin und her. So this is a funny image to me. Hin und her, if you don't know the phrase. You know the words, I'm sure, but hin und her is to and fro, back and forth, up and down. So he ran up and down the street. I kind of like imagine him like sobbing or something here, which just makes me laugh, but let's be nice to Alphonse Clénat. He's doing his job. Als die aufgehende Sonne. So as the rising sun, rise in German is pretty easy to know as aufgehen, to go up, to go on or go up. As the rising sun durch den Nebel brach und den Toten beschien, right, broke through the fog and lit the dead body, shone upon the dead body or lit him up, war ihm das unangenehm. Right, so he was unangenehm is like not so good, like pretty bad. It's sort of like a nicht recht schlecht, right? Nicht recht schlimm, aber nicht so gut auf jeden Fall, right? So not so good. So he's not feeling so good as the sun rises and lights the dead body. He's like, oh, this is not good. This is not good. Er kehrte zum Wagen zurück, hob den grauen Filzhut auf, hob den grauen, ja, Filzhut auf. So he went back to the car. Lifted a gray felt is felt cap, lifted it up, aufheben, hob auf. Make sure you know the simple past for these books. Like you should know this if you're reading books. If you don't, go and study. So this is aufheben, lifting up. Der zu, so what about the Filzhut? Der zu. We're gonna throw this page away. Oh, I forgot what I was reading. Okay, we're gonna have to combo it up. Okay, Filzhut, der zu Füßen der Leiche lag, right? That lay at the feet of the corpse. Und drückte ihr den Hut über den Kopf so tief, dass er die Wunde an den Schläfen nicht mehr sehen konnte. Dann war ihm wohler. Okay, so this is not a hard-boiled cop, right? This is not in any sense a hard-boiled guy. So this, he picks up this felt cap, drückte ihr den Hut über den Kopf, ihr referring to. So why we're saying ihr when it's a guy, it's die Leiche. How do you know? Right, Füßen der Leiche, Genitiv. Right, we know it's feminine. Über den Kopf, so he presses it over the corpse's head so deep that he can no longer, nicht mehr sehen konnte, that he could no longer see the wounds at the temples, right? Wunde an den Schläfen, nicht mehr sehen konnte. Dann war ihm wohler. So he's feeling pretty sick until he just pulls his cap and basically just covers up this guy's whole head. He's like, I don't need to see this. And now he suddenly feels better. Der Polizist ging wieder zum anderen Straßenrand, der gegen Twan lag, und wischte sich den Schweiß von der Stirne. He went to the other side of the street that was on the Twan side, that gegen Twan lag. He was on the Twan side, basically. Und wischte sich den Schweiß von der Stirne. Wiped himself the sweat. Right? Remember, body parts always almost reflexive. So he wiped himself the sweat from the forehead. He wiped sweat off his forehead. Dann fasste er einen Entschluss, right? Entschließen, the verb entschließen. Entschließen means just to decide, like entscheiden. It's basically the same thing, a conclusion or determination. So fasste, he gripped or he grabbed onto a conclusion. So basically he came to a decision. Er schob den Toten auf den zweiten Vordersitz, setzte ihn sorgfältig aufrecht, befestigte den leblosen Körper mit einem Lederriemen, den er am Wageninnern gefunden hatte, und rückte selbst ans Steuer. Okay, so I can sort of see this in my head as he's going. He's just doing this like, it's like, oh, what am I going to do? Er schob den Toten auf den zweiten Vordersitz. He shoved or pushed the body, the dead man, into the second Vordersitz. Vorder, good prefix to know. It means forelying, like fore, what's a good word? Well, it's in the front. Vorder something is the thing in the front. So the Vordersitz is the front seat, obviously. Zweiten Vordersitz, so that's the passenger seat. Actually, I don't know if there's a specific word for passenger seat. This might be the only way to say passenger seat in German, but something to look up for myself, actually. Setzte ihn sorgfältig aufrecht. So that was a little violent. So he carefully, taking care, sits him upright. Befestigte den leblosen Körper mit einem Lederriemen. Right, befestigte. So he sort of like dons, puts on him the lifeless body with a Lederriemen. Right, and Riemen is like a strip or a strap of something. Doesn't this guy have a seatbelt? Well, it's 1948, probably not. So he finds der er im Wageninnern gefunden hatte. Okay, so he finds this strip of leather in the interior of the car. Und rückte selbst ans Steuer. Okay, he puts himself behind the wheel. Der Motor lief nicht mehr. The motor would no longer run. Doch brachte Clinan den Wagen ohne Mühe. So he put himself. Yeah, I just said that. Brachte Clinan den Wagen ohne Mühe die steile Straße nach Twan hinunter von den Bären. Den Bären. I think that's mountains. I'm not an expert on the geography of Switzerland, which you may have to be if you actually want to get a full picture of this. But Bären, either the mountains or it's a region or something. Mountains or trees. I could have researched this before I gave this, but I just read through this once before I did this, so it's a little spontaneous. Maybe that's better, maybe that's awful. Let's see how it turns out. So, Clinan brought the wagon without effort, ohne Mühe, die steile Straße nach Twan hinunter, down to the steep street, Nachtfahren hinunter vor den Bären. So the street downwards, the street that goes downwards before or in front of den Bären, which is, again, we think Miss Mountains or Woods. I'm sorry, I should look this up. So he takes it down the street, right? In die steile Straße hinunter. So basically this is, so he ohne Mühe, how is he pushing this car? So doch, again, this is negating what he just tried. I just wanted to point this out. Same usage as before we saw on the last page. So he rückte sich selbst an Steuer, doch. So rather than doing this, what he was planning here, he's going to do this. Okay, that's probably show up to all, but whatever. So instead of doing what he was planning here, driving, he's going to bring it down this street towards Twan. Okay. So, without effort, because hinunter, it's eine steile Straße hinunter. So it's a steep street that leads downward. So that's easy. Dort ließ er tanken, ohne dass jemand in der vornehmen und unbeweglichen Gestalt Ja, unbewegliche Gestalt einen Toten erkannt hätte. And so there he filled it with gas. Tanken. That's how they say fill something with gas. Ohne dass jemand, specifically a car or a vehicle, I think. I'm no expert, you know. Ohne dass jemand der vornehmen und unbeweglichen Gestalt. So this is careful. This is not a verb. Vornehmen, to undertake. Not a verb. What are people who are vornehmen? Vornehmen. This is Adjektivendung. What are people who are vornehmen? These are people who, I guess, would say they undertake a lot of things. Vornehmen specifically means like stately. Or, I guess you would say, particularly nice-looking, really just, you know, stately and proper, prim and proper. So he's got, like, a perfect stately expression, but it's also, Gestalt is like face, but more like the expression or the general look. Ohne dass jemand in der vornehmen und unbeweglichen Gestalt, so in his stately and unmoving presence or appearance, einen Toten erkannt hätte. So he filled up with gas without anyone having been able to recognize the stately and unmoving form of a dead man. All right. Das war kleiner, der Skandale hasste, nur recht, und so schwieg er. Okay, so even though he's freaking out earlier, er schwieg, right? He was quiet. He kept quiet. So that was kleiner. Der Skandale hasste. So he hated scandals. Nur recht, und so schwieg er. Okay. Wie er jedoch den See entlang gegen Biel fuhr, verdichtete sich der Nebel wieder, und von der Sonne war nichts mehr zu sehen. Okay. So this is sort of like saying, continuing on from the last sentence, as he, however, went along the See, the Der See, right? The water here, the lake. Entlang gegen Biel fuhr. So he drove along the sea towards Biel. Gegen means against, but if you think of just a quick, like, you know, if here's this thing, you're driving against it, well, you're really driving sort of towards it or in the general direction. Verdichtete sich der Nebel wieder und von der Sonne war nichts mehr zu sehen. Verdichten, dicht, dick, thick, dicht, verdichten, to become thick. The fog further, yet more, wieder again, thickened. Und von der Sonne war nichts mehr zu sehen. There was nothing more to see of the sun. So he's driving along against the water and the fog is getting thicker. He can't see the sun anymore. Der Morgen wurde finster wie der letzte Tag. Okay, the day became... So it's not... So this is interesting. The morning, rather, became finster, dark. Dark in the sense of, like, more foreboding. Not just dunkel, but finster. So it looks like the word, a little bit like the word sinister. That's how I kind of remember the association. It's dark, but sinister. How sinister and dark? Wie der letzte Tag. Look at this. Capitalized letzte. I think that's, I mean, that's obviously like the apocalypse, right? But it may be, what is it called? I can't remember the word in English. It's like a Christian thing when Christ is supposed to return, you know, and like call the Armageddon, basically, right? So that's what he's saying. It's dark like Armageddon. Clinin geriet mitten in eine lange Automobilkette. So Automobilkette, you probably, if you've never heard this word, you know what Kette means. If you know what Kette means, it means a chain or series, a string maybe. Automobilkette, so you probably instantly know what this is. You've probably been in this. It's not a traffic jam, but eine Kette is just a long chain of cars together. And why is that? So poor Klina, 1948, is doing the same thing, dealing with the same things that you do on your morning commute. You and I both probably, if you commute. Ein Wagen hinter dem anderen. So one car after the other. So he fell, so like he went into, it sort of has a negative sense. He wound up in the middle of a long chain of cars. One car behind the other. so one car behind the other, die aus einem unerklärlichen Grunde noch langsamer fuhr, als es in diesem Nebel nötig gewesen wäre. Fast ein Leichenzug, wie Clenard unwillkürlich dachte. Okay. Ein Wagen mit dem anderen. Die aus einem unerklärlichen Grunde, die Kette, was for an unexplainable reason driving even slower than was necessary, would have been necessary in this fog. Almost a Leichenzug. Zug means like a pull, but you know there's a lot of words for it. A pull or a move or a train. And we know Leichen is corpses. So a train of corpses, that sounds awfully nasty. Es klingt irgendwie quasi finster. Leichenzug is a funeral procession. So very direct in German. Wie Klinger unwillkürlich dachte, unwillingly or unintentionally. So he's driving along in this and he just, of course, this sort of excitable or like somewhat fragile temperament, this cop with this fragile temperament goes along. He gets stuck in this chain of cars going way too slow and he's like, oh God, it's like a funeral procession. Der Tote saß bewegungslos neben ihm und nur manchmal bei einer Unebenheit der Straße etwa nickte er mit dem Kopf wie ein alter, weiser Chinese, so dass Clenard es immer weniger zu versuchen wagte, die anderen Wagen zu überholen. Okay, so this guy can't catch a break. This is pretty funny. A little sort of like, it's kind of dark humor here. I don't know if it's supposed to be funny or if I'm just a little messed up, but the dead body sat without moving. Los, you should know this. Los means without. So if you say something los, it means something without. So arbeitslos is unemployed, right? Without work, right? Ahnungslos, without an Ahnung, without an idea. So ahnungslos is like dumbfounded. Bewegungslos, without moving. So still, it's another way of saying still. Still is a word in German, but we're writing a novel. We don't need to be too short. Again, next to him, and only sometimes, bei einer Unebenheit, uneven. So an unevenness, right? Whenever you hit an unevenness, Unebenheit der Straße etwa, nickte er mit dem Kopf. He nodded his head every time he went over a bump, basically. Wie ein alter, weiser Chinese, like an old, wise Chinese man. So dass Clenard es immer weniger zu versuchen wagte, so that he would try ever, so he would, so this is, he dared less and less. Immer weniger, important to know. Immer plus an adjective, right? In the comparative form, like more, like größer, right? Bigger, klüger, smarter, whatever, kleiner, smaller. Immer weniger, so less and less, right? So that's adjective and adjective, right? So immer größer would be bigger and bigger, right? Immer dümmer would be dumber and dumber. So immer weniger, less and less. So he dared to try less and less, die anderen Wagen zu überholen, to overtake or pass the other cars. Okay, so this guy is, he's driving along. Every time he hits a bump or any unevenness of the road, Unebenheit der Straße etwa, the guy sort of nods his head. Like, he calls him an old, wise Chinese man. So this is a little stereotyping. It's the 50s. So this freaks him out more. So he doesn't even try to overtake the cars. He's stuck. Sie erreichten them together. Biel mit großer Verspätung. Very late. They arrived in Biel very late. Während man die Untersuchung der Hauptsache nach von Biel einleitete, I'm gonna move this up, sure I don't mess that up. Von Biel aus einleitete, wurde in Bern der traurige Fund Kommissär Berlach übergeben, der auch Vorgesetzter des Toten gewesen war. Okay. So while the investigation, wenn die Untersuchung der Hauptsache nach von Biel aus einleitete. So yeah, this is interesting. Die Untersuchung der Hauptsache, the main thing. So die Untersuchung der Hauptsache. So this is sort of saying like the investigation of the most important detail, right? So while someone, while one or a person, people were leading the investigation into the most important detail. So this is, of course, his cause of death, why he got murdered. Nach von Biel aus, right? Nach von Biel aus. So this is saying just like from out of Biel. So while this is happening, the investigation is going, wurde in Bern der traurige Fund Kommissar Berlach übergeben, right? So in Bern, the tragic find of Kommissar Berlach was given over, handed over to Kommissar Berlach, right? Who also Vorgesetzter des Toten war, gewesen war. Okay, so remember this guy he found. He knows this guy is another police officer. So he gives him over to the Kommissar Berlach, this guy, and he's the Vorgesetzter. So Vorsetzen is it would be like literally to set forward. Right, Vorsetzen, to set forward. Right, Vorgesetzt is like promoted or sitting above somebody. Okay, so he's the boss. Okay, Vorsetzen, er sitzt vor. Right, he's sitting in a position of power. He's the boss. So he was actually the guy's. So the guy's dead body is given to the man who was his boss when he was alive. Berlach hatte lange im Ausland gelebt und sich in Konstantinopel und dann in Deutschland als bekannte Kriminalist hervorgetan. Okay. Berlach had for a long time in, what's this in English? Abroad. He lived abroad for a long time und sich in Konstantinopel und dann in Deutschland als bekannte Kriminalist hervorgetan. Hervortun, right? Hervor, getan, ist really tun. So. Hervortun. So, tun is obviously do. Hervor is what kind of motion? From here forward. So he did it. He did forward, right? So what that really means is he became known as, or he proved himself to be. He became renowned for being. Right? He put himself forward as a known criminalist, criminal justice person in Konstantinopel und dann in Deutschland. Right, so he lived abroad, not in Switzerland, and he became renowned as a well-known criminologist or criminal justice official person. Zuletzt war er der Kriminalpolizei Frankfurt am Main vorgestanden. So he was promoted, or he got a position really, into the Kriminalpolizei Frankfurt am Main. This, I don't know what the best English equivalent of this is, but it's obvious what it means, right? Criminal police. What other kinds of police were there in Frankfurt am Main in 1948? I don't know, man. Don't ask me. I'm no expert. So, however, he returned soon, or he did indeed return, zurückkehrte. Well, I'm pretty sure it's going to say zurück because of my instincts, but yes, it does. Kehrte 33 in seine Vaterstadt zurück. He returned to his fatherland, his homeland, in the year 1933. Dates, years in Germans don't really ever take prepositions. So kehrte 33 zurück would imply almost definitely he returned in 1933. In 33, right? Like we say in English, in 33. This is happening in 48. So this guy has a bit of a history. Der Grund seiner Heimreise, the reason for his home trip. Heim is your home. Reise is a trip, so home trip. Reason for his trip home. War nicht so sehr seine Liebe zu Bern, so was not exactly his love of Bern, dass er oft sein goldenes Grab nannte, right? He often called it his golden grave, it's funny, sondern eine Ohrfeige gewesen, die er einem hohen Beamten der damaligen neuen deutschen Regierung gegeben hatte. Ooh, not a good time in the 30s to be giving an Ohrfeige. Ohrfeige is a strike on the ear. Right. The Germans say Ohrfeige a lot, and sometimes I don't think they literally mean a strike on the ear. It can be like maybe kind of figurative. But in this case, it's definitely not. So either literally a strike on the ear, or he beat somebody up, basically. And who did he beat up? Uh-oh. Ein hoher Beamte? Ein hoher Beamter der damaligen neuen deutschen Regierung. Okay. A high-ranking official of the, at that time, new German regime. Uh-oh. So he beat up a very important Nazi, probably. In Frankfurt wurde damals über diese Gewalttätigkeit viel gesprochen. Und in Bern bewertete man sie, je nach dem Stand der europäischen Politik, zuerst als empörend, dann als verurteilenswert, aber doch noch begreiflich und endlich sogar als die einzige für einen Schweizer mögliche Haltung. Dies aber erst 45. So, based on the status of European politics, it was considered first as empörend. This is a great word, empörend. Say this to your German friends. Das ist aber empörend. Right? And they will think you're interesting. So this empörend is just like, it's like beyond the pale. Like it's just sickening, sickening. This is sickening, sickening behavior. Dann als verurteilenswert, aber doch noch begreiflich. So it was worthy of condemning, but yet still kind of understandable, yet still within the realm of acceptability. Und endlich sogar, so even, finally, even as the only possible behavior for a Swiss man. This came around 45. Okay, around 45. So as the Nazis get a little crazier and World War II rages on, people start hating this guy even more. So he's like, well, this is awful. And wait, no, this needs to is verurteilenswert, so this could definitely imply the law should get involved. So actually, no, he should be hunted down. This guy should be hunted down, maybe put in jail. I mean, we understand why he did it. It's within the realm of acceptability. For somebody, it's reasonable that a normal person might do this, but he should be in big trouble. But finally, this is just Swiss people. They're just like this. And this came around 45, right? Oh my goodness. All right, so that's funny. Das Erste, was Berlach im Fall Schmid tat, war, dass er anordnete, so der Fall Schmid, this is how they talk about criminal stuff. You'll see this a lot in Krimis, too. Der Fall Schmid, der Fall? Schmid? So this is the Schmid case, right? They talk about this all the time. And if you watch a German crime shows, like there's a lot of German crime shows about missing people and stuff like that. Aktenzeichen XY is the one I like. So they talk about der Fall blank. So the case of blank. So in the case of Schmid, which is this guy's name, in case you've forgotten already, which I almost did when I read this. It's like Schmid. Who's this Schmid? Because that does mean, I think, Smith. Literally means Smith, like somebody, like a forge, some guy who sits at a forge. So, if any Germans came to America and their last name there were Schmidt, maybe they became Smiths. But anyway, so the first thing he did in the Schmidt case was to decree, to order people, anordnen, die Angelegenheit die ersten Tage geheim zu behandeln. So he decreed that on the occasion of the first days, es muss geheim behandelt werden, right? It has to be handled secretively. Right? So he decreed that the case in the first few days would be handled secretly. Eine Anordnung, a decree, die nur mit dem Einsatz seiner ganzen Persönlichkeit durchzubringen vermochte. Right? That he was only able to bring about, durchbringen, to bring through. In English, that's like bring about. Right? There's a lot of words like this, durchführen, right? To carry out or to carry out like duties or something. Or to bring, literally to bring through. So he only got this through by using his entire personality, right? He only managed to do that, like, so this was not easy for him to manage, keeping the secret, but he was like, you know, he used every sort of trick of persuasion that he had at his beck and call to do this. And he says, man weiß zu wenig und die Zeitungen sind sowieso das Überflüssigste, was in den letzten 2000 Jahren erfunden worden ist, meinte er. So he says, people know too little and newspapers are, in any way, sowieso, newspapers are Das Überflüssigste. Überflüssig, literally overflowing, like overflowing, but he means like the most superfluous or useless thing that in the last 2,000 years has become invented, right? So this is they're the most useless things that have ever been invented. They're the most overblown things ever. And so he's like, the papers can't get a hold of this. Berlach schien sich von diesem geheimen Vorgehen offenbar viel zu versprechen, im Gegensatz zu seinem Chef, Dr. Lucius Lutz, der auch auf der Universität über Kriminalistik las. Okay, so this is sort of the, the 40s going into the 50s, where it's like, wait a second, this whole criminology thing, we can actually like use science and means testing and social studies and stuff like that to figure out how best to deal with this. So this is a, sort of plays a big part here. So Berlach is using his knowledge to say, I know what we can do. We can make keep this secret so the papers don't get a hold of it. It'll make our investigation a lot cleaner. And so he seems to be promising much from this secret process. He was clearly promising a lot. So that's in contrast with his chief or his boss, Dr. Lucius Lutz. Lucius? Lucius, I think, is right. Lucius Lutz, der auch auf der Universität über Kriminalistik las. So this Berlach guy, he's not the only one with some big ideas. This guy also read about criminology at university. Dieser Beamte, in dessen stadtbernisches Geschlecht ein Basler Erbonkel wohltuend eingegriffen hatte, war eben von einem Besuch der New Yorker und Chicagoer Polizei nach Bern zurückgekehrt. This is a long sentence. Und erschüttert über den vorweitlichen Stand der Verbrecherabwehr der schweizerischen Bundeshauptstadt, die er zu Polizeidirektor Freiberger anlässlich einer gemeinsamen Heimfahrt im Tram offen sagte. Oh boy, long one. Sorry, so this. So this worker, this colleague, this official, in dessen stadtbernes Geschlecht, so stadtbernes Geschlecht, this Geschlecht means sex or gender, but this is stadtbernisch, so regarding or about the Stadt, city of Bern. So he has, so this, really in this case, this actually means like origin or his lineage, his pedigree. So in his City of Bern pedigree, ein Basler Erbonkel, right? A ba Basler, I had to look this up, I'll be honest, when I first read it. This is just a location. So someone from Basel, Basler Erbonkel, an Erbonkel, Erb, that comes from, means basically lineage or inheritance also. So we don't want to use the same word, we use a different word. Uncle, so a sort of like a lineage uncle or an inheritance uncle, that literally just means a rich uncle. Like, you know how we have the, like, in English we talk about, oh, that he got into, university, or he can only afford this because he's got some rich uncle, or maybe I'll strike it big and some I have some rich uncle, right? Erbonkel, same in German, same idea. So, wohltuend eingegriffen hatte. So, some rich uncle had wohltun, so wohltuend. Right, is giving means, monetary means. Eingegriffen hatte. So some rich uncle had made his way into this guy's Bern lineage and put some money in there. Okay. Er war eben so this, so that's gonna explain why he was eben von einem Besuch der New Yorker und Chicagoer Polizei. So he just spent a visit with the police in New York and Chicago. This is what he does, because he has a rich uncle. It's somewhere in his history. Nach Bern zurück. So he came back to Bern und erschüttert. He shakes in just anger or fear or in general upsetness. Über den vorweitlichen Stand der Verbrecherabwehr der schweizerischen Bundeshauptstadt. Right? So he's shaken, or he just shakes with worry or rage or something over the vorweltlich, so vorwelt, before the world, vorweltlich. So something that's before the world is like prehistorical. So when we talk about something's primitive, prehistorical, in German they say vorweltlich, before the world. So he shakes over the primitive state der Verbrecherabwehr. If you know Abwehr, Panzerabwehrkanone from World War II history or World War II games or something. Abwehr ist defense against. So Verbrecher is an offender, a criminal offender. So defense against criminal offenders. So this would be like, I can't think of a good English word for this off the top of my head, and I don't want to wait for a minute or two. My brain starts working. So this will be a challenge for you. Just figure out a way to translate this accurately. What's the English word for this? Verbrecherabwehr. Oh, I just thought of the word, but I'm not going to say it. I already gave the challenge. Über den vorweltlichen Stand der Verbrecherabwehr der Schweizerischen Bundeshauptstadt. All right. So he's talking about the sorry prehistoric state of dealing with criminals in the Swiss capital, Bundeshauptstadt. So this is quoting him. Wie zu Polizeidirektor Freiberger anlässlich einer gemeinsamen Heimfahrt im Tram offen sagte. So he would just literally say to the Polizeidirektor Freiberger, on the occasion of, this is always followed by dative, by the way. Or not dative, genitive. But of course, people don't like the genitive, so they sometimes use the dative. Anlässlich means on the occasion of a shared ride home in the tram. He would say this openly, offen sagte, to the Polizeidirektor. Okay, hopefully that wasn't totally out of frame. My hand is drifting because I'm getting lazy and stuff. Noch am gleichen Morgen ging Berlach, nachdem er noch einmal mit Biel telefoniert hatte, zu der Familie Schönler an der Bantigerstraße. Bantiger oder Bantiger? I think Bantigerstraße, wo Schmied gewohnt hatte. Okay. Noch am gleichen Morgen ging Berlach. So, on that same morning, so later, noch means yet, but in this case we'll translate it as later. Later on that same morning, Berlach went by foot. After he noch einmal mit Biel telefoniert hatte, after he'd talked to Biel, right? He talked to him by phone. He went to der Familie Schönler an der Bantigerstraße. He went to the Schönler family an Bantigerstraße, wo Schmied gewohnt hatte. So this guy lived in a shared house rented from the Schönler family. Berlach schritt zu Fuß die Altstadt hinunter und über die, I hate this, I have no idea how to pronounce this. Nüdigbrücke? Nüdig? It's Swiss, so I feel like there's got to be a ch in there. Nüdigbrücke. So he's walking through the Altstadt, down into the Altstadt and over the Nüdigbrücke, the bridge. Wie es immer gewohnt war. Wie es immer gewohnt war. Careful. Not wohnen, but gewohnen. Not wohnen, not live, but gewohnen. He's used to it. As he had always been used to doing. Den Bern war seiner Ansicht nach eine viel zu kleine Stadt für Trams und dergleichen. Right? Bern was much too small in his opinion, in his view. Seiner Ansicht nach, right? Like meiner Meinung nach, seiner Meinung nach, seiner Ansicht nach. So in his view, in his point of view. It was much too small. It was a much too small city for trams and the like, and some such things. Okay, die Haspeltreppen. So this is another thing I had to check. This is another situation where there's just it's Swiss stuff. Haspeltreppen is just a part of the city. Treppen would be like, so Haspel. I think, what is Haspel? Actually, I think this is a word for like some construction equipment or like a mechanical thing. And Treppen means stairs, but this is just the name of a place. So it's like whatever this is, like if we call it like a, I'm not sure what it is. So it's a place, Haspeltreppen. So I'll just say that so I don't have to translate that. It is a place though. Stieg etwas mühsam hinauf, denn war über 60 und spürte das in solchen Momenten. So this guy is not only, so here's something that tells us about this guy. He's a little bit of a, he's a little bit weak in the knees. Like he's not a hard-boiled detective, police officer. He's also stubborn. So it says, Haspeltreppen stieg he climbed the Haspeltreppen. So Haspeltreppen, normally you would eine Treppe steigen, right? You climb a stairway in German. But in this case, it's sort of a place. So I'm assuming this is probably like some high street that goes like way up. And maybe there's even like stairs there, right? But I don't know. I didn't research this. Mühsam, with effort, right? He climbed the Haspeltreppen with somewhat of effort, right? With a decent amount of effort. Because he was over 70, 60, sorry, he's over 60 and felt it in certain moments, in such moments, sorry, in solchen Momenten. In such moments, he felt it, spüren, to feel, right? We usually hear sich anfühlen oder sich fühlen, spüren is to sense something physically, specifically. Doch befand er sich, so he's stubborn, right? He's saying, I don't need trams or something. The city's tiny. And then he's going up this incline. And he's like, oh man, he's all right. He's panting and stuff. You can imagine he's over 60. Doch befand er sich bald vor dem Haus schöner und läutete. Okay. So despite this, here's another use of doch, or that's not, we saw this one before, but, or despite that, befand er sich bald, he soon found himself in front of the, of dem Hause. So here's Data V again. We've been seeing it a ton. I'm just going to point out here. In case you're wondering, zu Hause, it comes from exactly this kind of thing. Vor dem Hause schönler und läutete. Right? Nothing to do with Leute. Nothing to do with this. But this is to ring. Right? To ring the doorbell or to knock. Er war Frau Schönler. Oh, es war Frau Schönler selbst, die öffnete. It was Frau Schönler herself, the lady of the house, right? The mother or wife that opened the door, right? Öffnen is just short in German for open a door, right? Right? Sie öffnete, implying the door. We don't need to go any further than that. In German, at least. Eine kleine, dicke, nicht unvornehme Dame, right? Here's vorname again, except this time she's unvornehm. She's a small, thick, so chubby. Not unvornehm. So vornehm was like a stately, someone of a stately appearance. Nicht unvornehm is she's not unelegant. She's not inelegant, right? So she's small, chubby, but she has a certain elegance to her. She's not inelegant. Dame, die Berlach sofort einließ, that immediately let Berlach in, because she knew him, da sie ihn kannte, because she knew him. Schmied musste diese Nacht dienstlich verreisen, sagte Berlach. Ganz plötzlich musste er gehen, und er hat mich gebeten, um etwas nachzuschicken. Ich bitte Sie, mich in sein Zimmer zu führen, Frau Schönler. So Schmied, so you see, this is him talking now. Schmied had to go this night, so depart on a trip, verreisen, nicht nur reisen, aber verreisen. Fair generally has a sense of going away or removing. So he's going off on a trip. Not just going on a trip, but going off on a trip, going away. Dienstlich. Dienst is duty. So dienstlich is in the line of duty. So that's a little melodramatic in English sounding. But Schmied musste diese Nacht dienstlich verreisen. He had to go away for work tonight. This night. The previous night or this night. Sagte Berlach, ganz plötzlich musste er gehen. He had to go quite suddenly. Ganz plötzlich, quite suddenly he had to go. Und er hat mich gebeten, he asked me, ihm etwas nachzuschicken. Nachschicken, send back. Send along, in this case, send along with him. So he asked me to send him something along. Ich bitte Sie, mich in sein Zimmer zu führen, Frau Schönler. I request to you, I ask you, take me into his room. Lead me into his room, Frau Schönner. So I'll ask you to please take me to his room, Frau Schönner. So he's being a little, he doesn't say bitte. He does say bit, well, that must have sounded really hilarious. He says bitte, he doesn't say please, but he says ich bitte Sie. I beg you, or I, sort of like in English, this old phrase, I prithee, right? I would like you to, would you please? So he's being sort of a business, like a cop should be. Die Dame nickte, she nodded, remember, like the guy nodding, like the Chinese man. Und sie ging durch den Korridor an einem großen Bilde in schwerem Goldrahmen vorbei. Okay. So, she nodded and went through the corridor along an einem großen Bilde, a large, this is Bild, but with a date of E on it. Bild, so a large image? No, in this case, we can assume not only it's not really just an image or a picture, but it's a large Schirmgoldrahmen, right? Golden case or a golden frame. So this is probably some large portrait, like a painting, or maybe like a giant family photograph, but that's probably not likely. Bialach schaute, so this is what was in the corridor in the hall. Bialach schaute hin. Es war die Toteninsel. Okay, he looked to it. Es war die Toteninsel. Right? It was the island of the dead. Oh my god, they're laying it on thick with this imagery, this poor guy. Wo ist Herr Schmied denn? Fragte die dicke Frau. He calls him dicke Frau. Asked the chubby woman. So where is he then? Asked the chubby woman. Indem sie das Zimmer öffnete. And then in as she, indem, whilst or as she opened the door to the room. Im Ausland, sagte Bärlach und schaute nach der Decke hinauf. So he just quickly says he's abroad. And he looks up at the ceiling, right? He doesn't want to look at her, for one. He doesn't want to look at the Toteninsel. You don't want to look at that when he's feeling guilty, since he's lying to her, right? Ein Lügner. Das Zimmer lag zu ebener Erde, right? It lay on even earth, on an even ground, right? So it was an even first floor Zimmer, room. Und durch die Gartentüre sah man in einen kleinen Park. So through the garden doors, so that's like the outside doors, you could see, one could see into, not in einem kleinen Park, but in einen, into a small park, in which old, in welchem alte braune Tannen standen, in which old brown Tannen is evergreen trees, fir trees specifically, I think, standen. So there's old brown fir trees standing there, die krank sein mussten, that must have been sick. Denn der Boden war dicht mit Nadeln bedeckt, right? Because the ground was thickly with needles bedeckt, covered. Okay? It was covered thick with needles. Es musste das schönste Zimmer des Hauses sein. Oh, he's feeling sentimental. He says, this must have been the nicest Zimmer, room. For some reason, I can never think of the English word when I see Zimmer. Room in the house. Must have been the nicest room in the house. Bärlach ging zum Schreibtisch und schaute sich auf Neues um. So, aufs Neue um. Misreading things. So, ging zum Schreibtisch und schaute sich aufs Neue um. Aufs Neue is like neu or wieder neu. It's just once again. Literally, like on the new. So he went to the writing desk, to the desk, and looked around himself once more. Looked around once more. Auf dem Divan lag eine Krawatte des Toten. Right? On the divan, on the. What is it in English? How do you say this? The divan? The divan? I don't know. You know what this is, right? Because I forget what this is in English. It's a, it's like a sofa. Lag eine Krawatte des Toten. A sofa chair, really. So there lay on the divan. Good God, man. The tie of the dead man. Herr Schmied ist sicher in den Tropen, nicht wahr, Herr Bärlach? Fragte ihn Frau Schöner neugierig. So he's Herr Schmied is definitely in the tropics. Isn't that true, Herr Bärlach? Frau Schöner curiously asked him curiously. Bärlach war etwas erschrocken. He got a bit of a shock. Like he's starting to get like he meant to just give this like one lie, and now she's asking him questions and he's like, oh God, I gotta lie more about this. I can't deal with this. He says, nein, ist nicht in den Tropen, ist mehr in der Höhe. Right? He's not in the tropics, he's more in the height, would mean in this case, he's more north. He's more high up. He could be more north, or really just, he's really more high up. So it's like, somewhere up. So not the tropics. Frau Schöner machte runde Augen. So she gets like wide doe eyes, runde Augen, round eyes. Und schlug die Hände über dem Kopf zusammen. So she's just this adorable, excitable lady. She throws, schlug, or strikes really, strikes, but in this case we can translate it in English as throws. Throws her hands over her head together. Mein Gott im Himalaya! In Himalaya? Maybe. I've never actually heard this word spoken in German. So ungefähr, sagte Bialach. Something like that. Approximately like that. Ungefähr is approximately, so like that. So approximately like that. Something like that, sagte Bialach. Sie haben es beinahe erraten. Right? He doesn't want her to keep guessing places and keep freaking him out. So he says, you've nearly guessed it. Right? Raten is to guess. But erraten, so this er usually means it's finished after you've done this, right? So if you think of in like, well, this is an appropriate example actually. Erschießen. Schießen is just to shoot. Erschießen is to shoot so that something's finished. You could interpret it as. So erschießen is specifically to kill by shooting, to shoot someone dead. So in this case, erraten is to guess so it's finished. So you've nearly guessed it correctly. So this should shut her up, he thinks. Öffnete eine Mappe, die auf dem Schreibtisch lag und die sogleich unter den Arm klemmte. So he opens up a folder, not a map, but a folder, die auf dem Schreibtisch lag, that was laying on the desk, und die sogleich, and that he immediately after, or at that time immediately, unter den Arm klemmte. He clapped it, or pinched it under his arm. Sie haben gefunden, was Sie Herrn Schmidt nachschicken müssen? Have you found what you have to send Herr Schmidt nachschicken müssen? Send. So this is like send after, right? So he's already departed. He's already gone. Nachschicken. So send after him. Send after him. Send to him. Das habe ich. I have. Right? So have you already found what you have to send him? I have. Yes. He wants to get out of there. Last page. Probably you haven't been listening to all this all once. If you have, oh my God, congratulations. Er schaute sich noch einmal um. So yet again, he looked around himself. We've said this, I think, 3 times now. Vermied es aber ein zweites Mal nach der Krawatte zu blicken. Right? He avoided it, however, but he did avoid ein zweites Mal nach der Krawatte zu blicken. Looking at the tie ein zweites Mal, a second time. Er ist der beste Untermieter, den wir je gehabt haben, und nie gab's Geschichten mit Damen oder so, versicherte Frau Schönler. This guy cannot catch a break. He's just feeling so sick right now. He's the best tenant. So mieten, ein Mieter is a renter. Untermieter is a subtenant, subletter. Right? He's a sub renter. So she's probably doesn't own this building, and he rents from her while she's also renting. So. Den wir je gehabt haben, that we've ever had. So he's the best tenant we've ever had. He's the best subletter we've ever had. And nie gab's Geschichten mit Damen oder so. Then the guy's, and this is almost a little sad. And there's never any stories, any problems. So this is literally stories. There's never been stories with ladies or such. Ladies and stuff like that. So this means, you know, he's not bringing ladies home every night and stuff like that. When really, I mean, this guy's an older policeman, right, that died. So I imagine him as old, but maybe we'll find out he's actually young. But he just rents in this place with this other family. He never has ladies around, and he died in some forest path, right? So it's kind of sad. So she assured him. So she's like trying to stick up for the guy. She loves this guy. Bialach ging zur Türe. Hin und wieder werde ich einen Beamten schicken oder selber kommen. Oder he says this, not her. Hin und wieder werde ich einen Beamten schicken oder selber kommen. Schmidt hat noch wichtige Dokumente hier, die wir vielleicht brauchen. So he's setting this up to say, like, obviously this guy's dead, so they may have to come back to collect evidence. So he's saying, hin und wieder, now and then, now and again, werde ich einen Beamten schicken oder selber kommen. Now and again, I'll send an officer or a representative, schicken, oder selber kommen, or come myself. Schmidt hat noch wichtige Dokumente hier. He still has important documents here, die wir vielleicht brauchen, that we may need. All right? So he's saying, you know, oh yeah, he's off on a trip and I got the thing I need to send him, but there may be a lot more that we need to get. Werde ich von Herrn Schmidt eine Postkarte aus dem Ausland erhalten? Wollte Frau Schöne noch wissen. So, will I get a postcard from Herr Schmied from abroad. Wollte Frau Schöne noch wissen, she still wanted to know. Mein Sohn sammelt Briefmarken, right? Her son collects stamps. Oh, such a nice lady. Aber Werler runzelte die Stirn und bedauerte, indem er Frau Schöne nachdenklich ansah. So he furrows his forehead. We say brow in English, but only because it's a set phrase. We don't really say brow anymore, like sweat of your brow or furrow your brow. That's the only time, right? Er runzelte die Stirne. Right, the Stirne is like, you know, forehead. Und bedauerte. So he's suffering, basically. Indem er Frau Schöne nachdenklich ansah. As he looked at her in thought. Nachdenklich. Right? Nachdenken is to think about something, to give thought to something. Nachdenklich is to do it in a way that you're giving thought. So he looks at her. He ansah. Er sieht sie an. Nachdenklich. In thought. Wohl kaum. Bin von solchen dienstlichen Reisen schickt man gewöhnlich keine Postkarten. Das ist verboten. Wohl kaum. Right? Indeed, or indeed, hardly. Wohl kaum. So he's saying, almost certainly not. Most certainly not. Bin von solchen dienstlichen Reisen, from such work trips, schickt man gewöhnlich keine Postkarten. You don't usually send. One doesn't usually send postcards from these kinds of work trips. Gewöhnlich, usually. Das ist verboten. That's forbidden. Da schlug Frau Schönle aufs Neue die Hände über dem Kopf zusammen und meinte verzweifelt, so she throws her hands up again, was die Polizei nicht alles verbietet. Alright, so this is a fun, we're but at the end, so I'll do a little bit on this phrase here. Alright, was nicht alles, blah, right? So that means this of all things, right? Was du nicht alles immer sagst, right? The things you say all the time, right? The, you know, of all things to say, right? Was die Polizei nicht alles verbietet. So, this is nicht alles. So, this is just sort of a set phrase you can use. Slot in things, verbs and objects here to get what something of all things or of all things. So you're saying the police forbid even that of all things, right? Verbieten. Right, is verbieten, which is, again, same word here, verboten. Das ist verboten. Verbietet. Same verb there. Was die Polizei nicht alles verbietet. The things the police forbid, she says. To think that the police would forbid such things. Berlach ging und war froh, aus dem Haus hinaus zu sein. So this poor woman has been left in her ignorance here. And just the nicest lady, and he has lied to her. And he goes and was happy. He went and was happy, aus dem Haus hinaus. So this is important in German. He was happy to be out of the house, right? So nicht nur aus dem Haus, hinaus, right? So this is common in German. It feels like we're repeating something in English when we repeat this. Because we know hin is from the speaker away, and aus is out or out of. So hinaus is a motion of going out, right? So he's not only out of the house, he has gone out. So in English, this seems repetitive, but in German, it's very common and a very normal way to word things. Aus dem Haus hinaus zu sein. So he was happy, like, to have gone out of the house, right? To have left the house. He's not only out of the house, but he has specifically gone out. That's what the hinaus is doing. Okay, that's it. Damit sind wir fertig. I hope it was okay. Hope it was interesting. And we'll see if we do more of these, maybe. This is a long, long thing. But if you watch to the end, congratulations. And we might see you again. All right. See you later, guys. Bye-bye. Tschüss.